Live from Washington, D.C. Jay Sekulow Live. Phone lines are open for your questions right now. And now, Chief Counsel for the American Center for Law and Justice, Jay Sekulow.
Welcome to the broadcast, everyone. So the Freedom From Religion Foundation, at it again. They went after a university in Northern Illinois, actually University of Northern Illinois, to get the Bibles out of their school or university hotels. And that school capitulated. Only place that's done it, by the way. So now they've gone on a national campaign, and that national campaign is basically this. They want to take Bibles out of, they want Bible-free rooms, and they want the hotels to provide Bible-free zones, basically, inside. And they went to the major hotel chains, Logan. So this is their new attack on this, and we're talking about it today. We're taking action, too, by the way. But this is their typical reaction.
That's right. They called for all the major hotel chains, all the major ones you can think of. So they're actually trying to force a private company to make a decision about keeping a Bible, removing the Bible, really none of their business. And it's just how the situation is unfolding is absolutely ridiculous. And we're here to help.
Freedom From Religion Foundation. It's Christmas, so why not ban the Bible? That should be their motto. It's Christmas. Let's ban the Bible.
Trying to remove prayer from the college football season. It was the week leading up to college football season. Everything is done very premeditated. Not that there's anything wrong with being you know, good at marketing, but you know, finding that time.
So what we're talking about, if you're joining us late or if you're catching us on our West Coast programming, the Bible makes gruesome bedtime reading. Atheist group seeks Bible-free hotel rooms nationwide. This, of course, is your friends, brought to you by your friends at the Freedom From Religion Foundation. We're going to go right to our phones. People have been holding.
Yep. All right. Let's go back to the phones. Let's go to Bruce, who's calling on line two from Broomfield, Colorado. Welcome. You're on JSecul Live.
Hey, Bruce. I'm sending you undemocratic. Go ahead.
Oh, thank you. I was going to say we should add that maybe we should rename the FFRF, because the way they're constantly attacking our religious expression, and change their name. I mean, it'd be more accurate to call them Bigots Against Religious Freedom, which makes the acronym BARF, sort of like the barfy.
Yeah,
bigot.
There you go. Well, I'm not going to, you know, that's clever. But here's the thing, and this is where you got to watch them, because in the University of Northern Illinois, Jordan, they were successful.
That's right. Not in court.
But in intimidation.
Sent one letter, doesn't ever really say that it's unconstitutional or illegal. It's more they don't like it, we feel uncomfortable. And Northern Illinois did it very quickly. And so they pulled the Bibles from their university hotels. And this was because, again, as a warning, don't invite Freedom From Religion Foundation to your places, because they go around looking. Again, they were searching the room for the Bible. So this was obviously something that they wanted to push with the school. They might have had a like-minded person there. They went right to the legal counsel at the school, and it was done quickly. That's why you have to take it serious, as difficult as it is, because they do try to intimidate, find people who agree with them, and somehow accomplish, try to move the ball forward with their goals.
So Will just sent the electric marquee on their building. So they have a building, and they've got a marquee, and they have electricity. Says, ho, 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 heathens greetings instead of seasons greetings. So they're advertising that they're heathens. And the University of Northern Illinois bows down to them. They're advertising, we're heathens, and that's what they're saying, so we're going to bow down to them. That's why, folks, sign on to this letter, aclj.org or 877-989-2255.
I have a comment just came in from Periscope from Guy Fox, who said, I bet if you dug into their backgrounds, you would find some great pain or hurt that they blame God for. And we know that is actually...
We had a caller,
and I believe they're working on a book about sort of the history of this, because Dan Barker was a pastor, essentially, right?
Yep, that's exactly right. And didn't we? And I think it was the guy that actually the son of the minister that at the church where Dan was ordained called in the broadcast.
Yeah, I think Dan had married him or married
hear if he's listening. Call us 1-800-684.
But there is a whole backstory.
3110. Yeah, 800-684-3110. All right, let's take another phone call, another comment.
All right, let's see who's been holding the longest. Try to take them before we go to break. Mike is calling from West Virginia on line 6.
Mike, really quick here. You've been holding. I'm sending you a book. Go ahead, Mike.
Thank you for taking my call. Those Bibles are not hurting anybody. If somebody wants to buy Darwin books and leave them in the hotel room, I'm okay with that. But I'd like to know where these people get their money from. They need to get a life.
They have donors. They want to ban the book. It's what Logan said early. You know, Nazis ban books. I mean, they want to ban that book, and they want the Bible banned, and or they want at least a Bible-free zone, if you want to call it that. Hey, we're taking a break. Thanks for calling, everybody. We're going to take more of your calls when we come back. ACLJ.org or 1-877-989-2255 to sign this petition. ACLJ.org or 1-877-989-2255. We'll be back with more. Don't forget our matching challenge campaign. Our email that's going out today is on the life issue. We've got a couple of briefs that we are filing at the Supreme Court of the United States. So if you get our emails, you're getting this from me. ACLJ.org or 1-877-989-2255 or ACLJ.org. Back with more in a moment.
Bibles, they're as common in hotels as those little shampoos and soaps hidden away in nightstand drawers. To the Freedom From Religion Foundation, they're much more than that. They say they're a way to force one religion onto travelers.
This one was easy and fast.
Yes, and Dan, you kindly chauffeured me when I was asked to speak at Northern Illinois University in DeKalb, Illinois. And you said, gee, you should look and make sure there isn't a Gideon Bible in our hotel room. And I was the skeptic, and I opened three drawers, no Bible. The fourth drawer, the bedside table, there it was. I was shocked.
These angry atheists will stop at nothing to attack Christianity. The American Center for Law and Justice has defeated this group numerous times in the past and is now mobilizing to combat this group's false and misleading information. Stand with the ACLJ now as we defend the Bible.
The Freedom From Religion Foundation's at it again. This time they went after the University of Illinois saying, well, you're a state-based university, so you're, you know, government funding there, and we don't want you to have government funding mixed with hotels. And the people at the University of Illinois initially caved. Now, we're working for them to understand that that's not a violation of the Constitution. Now they're requesting basically a Bible-free hotel rooms. And those Bible-free hotel rooms are being put in place because this is the quote, the Bible makes, quote, gruesome bedtime reading. Now, I wish I could say this was a joke, but it's not. And they would rather have in those rooms Darwin's Origin of the Species. So this is the Freedom From Religion Foundation. This is what they spend their time doing.
And someone just commented about this. They want to replace the Bible with their version of the Bible, essentially.
Right.
It's not like they're like, you know, we're going to call for just nothing. You know, we don't want anything. They're like, no. You need to replace it what we think is right. That's pretty interesting. I said during the break, when have you ever stayed in a hotel and complained about getting something for free? Okay, come on now. Freedom From Religion Foundation. Everything's always a $13 can of Coke. You know,
giving sponsorship here?
Yeah, okay, a can of soda.
There you go.
Generic soda, like in a sitcom. You know, I'm just joking around, but it's really true. It's like, who's having a problem with this? No one. No one has an issue with this.
We have that bite where she plays. She said she was, you know, in the hotel room and she was searching through the drawers. But Jordan, this is, you know, we're having some fun with this today. But the truth is, we've got 163,000 people that have contacts. We're going to get it up to 200,000 people. They don't win lawsuits, but they intimidate like crazy.
Well, that's right. And the Gideon's Bibles play an important role. I mean, they are there. The Gideons on their own fact page of their website talk about how, you know, each Bible, which is an interesting fact, has about a 6-year lifespan. Either someone may take it with them. And they encourage that to some extent as well.
Right.
About 2,300 people in that 6-year lifespan will actually open the Bible while they're traveling on the road. And listen, there are hotels that place other holy books or their religious yep. books in the drawer. The Marriott chains have the Book of Mormon. A lot of people probably don't even know that, but it's just, again, it's because they go searching for a problem, and they're trying to pressure like-minded folks into saying, in the corporate world, in the university world, to say, okay, let's do what the Freedom From Religion Foundation wants. That's where they get their victories. I think they're trying to find people who agree with them, and now they're trying the corporate world. They've sent this out to every major hotel chain, 15 hotel chains, the Wyndham, Marriott, Best Western, Holiday Inn, Quality Inn, Hilton, Motel 6, Radisson, Carlson, and Country Inn have all gotten this request to remove Bibles.
By the way, Marriott, which is a predominantly LDS-owned or run company,
right.
They've got the Bible there and the Book of Mormon. I can guarantee you they're not taking
that. Yeah, how can you tell a private business at that point that you can't put up? I mean, obviously they can't tell them, but you know, when essentially you go to that business and everyone probably stayed in a Marriott, you've seen the fact that they have the Book of Mormon. If you don't agree with it, you don't have to pick it up. Not exactly something that's really hard to do. It's just going to be bullying and see if they can bully their way into a victory here.
They are so bent on getting this information, though, that let me play for you what they said. I mean, this is, they go on a search and destroy mission for Bibles in hotel room. They have nothing better to do than to search and destroy for Bibles in a hotel. Listen, this is from Annie Gaylor.
Another victory from high school to the college level. This one was easy and fast.
Yes, and Dan, you kindly chauffeured me when I was asked to speak at Northern Illinois University in DeKalb, Illinois. And you said, gee, you should look and make sure there isn't a Gideon Bible in our hotel room. And I was the skeptic, and I opened three drawers, no Bible. The fourth drawer, the bedside table, there it was. I was shocked.
She was shocked. This is a woman that has nothing better to do than get shocked over a Gideon Bible in a hotel.
There were letters in a piece of papers, all attached and bound.
And she's shocked.
And she's shocked and decides, then she's compelled to read it, I guess. So maybe then
that's a good thing.
Victory.
Yeah, for us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to take your calls, 1-800-684-3110. Here's what we want you to do. Sign on to this letter, and let me tell you why. We got 163,000 signatures. We're going to have representation from all 50 states going to all these major hotel chains that Jordan mentioned, and we're going to fight back on this. So ACLJ.org or 1-877-989-2255. We want you to add your name again, ACLJ.org or 877-989-2255.
And the Freedom From Religion Foundation in the past, haven't they also, like, they give out the warning labels they want you to actually take into hotel chains?
Yeah,
and,
Jordan,
and so, to put them on the Bible. So obviously they're also calling for, yeah, previously the destruction of some of these or you know.
What is it that they want you to do with those Bible? Do we have a picture that we could show our Facebook audience?
Yeah, I have one. Hold on.
Okay, Logan's going to show one. But Jordan, what do they want you to do with these warning labels?
Put them on Gideon's Bibles. Yeah. And so, I mean, they've been doing that for a long time, encourage people to place that's black and yellow. And for people who are not watching, they can, who listen and see, it's got skull and crossbones on it.
And this book may endanger your health and life. And they want you to do that on someone else's property, which is real nice. You know, that's a great way
so
to do
are
it.
Are they having you put this on? I mean, they want this on the...
On the hotel Bibles.
So they want you to desecrate the hotel Bible.
They've been calling that for years. Now they just want them completely removed. Can we take a call?
We can.
Let's go to Joe, who's calling from Lakeland, Florida. I just like his comments. Fun.
Hi, Joe.
Hi. How are you today? Thank you for taking my call.
Sure.
I was wondering, can the motel chains just charge extra for Bible-free rooms?
Yep. Let's see how many people decide to spend that extra money. I think that's a good call, Joe. I think if anything,
it's a private company, they can do whatever they want.
That would be a nice compromise if they decide, because we'll see how many of those rooms sell. You know, if there's a Bible-free room, it's an extra $40 a night. You know, like you can sometimes do like the no allergies room. There'll be the no Bible room. You know, yeah, I have a feeling they're going to get a lot more flack on the other side by offering that. But it is a funny comment, Joe. I think you're right, though, that it would be nice to see if they decide to cave in a way that would even anger more.
Yeah,
the FFRF.
Charge them more for that.
Charge
but let me ask this question. We our lines are jammed right now, but if you can get through, how many of you have actually looked at that Gideon Bible when you've been in a hotel room? I have.
For sure.
I mean, I like Jordan, what did you say the life of the Bible is about, what, 6 years?
Yeah, it's about 6 years, 2,300 people, and so ultimately the Gideons replace. I mean, so it's, again, I think it has more of an impact than even we may all imagine being in that drawer. But again, it's not in your face. I think it's something that as Americans we know is likely there in the room. But these days, I mean, it just seems like with the access people have, why did this upset them so much? I mean, you can find whatever holy text you want as well through online and on your tablet, but having it there, it's a decision by these businesses to allow it. They have the right to do it. And I think the universities do as well, by the way. I don't think
Absolutely.
That it has to extend there. And we need to make sure that on that side also that we fight back, because that's really where they try to find their victories. They try to find people like them in the university structure. That's probably the easiest place for them to find support, honestly, and who will carry out these policies.
All right, we're taking your calls, 1-800-684-3110, 800-684-3110. Any more comments from Facebook and Periscope? You want to grab a phone call?
Yeah, we can take a comment or two. Let me pull up a good one right here. A lot of them just said, why are they so afraid? The Bibles never attack anyone. They're just sitting there. These are not gruesome scenes
that
people see in action movies that are available in these hotel rooms. That was from Abigail. You know, there's a lot worse things that you can obviously have your children subjugated to or whatever it be directly from the hotel chains. You don't hear anyone complaining about that.
Here's the reality. It's what Jordan said is right. They went after the universities because they concocted a church-state argument, which was absurd. The Bible having a Bible in a university-owned hotel room does not violate the Establishment Clause. Does anybody believe that establishes a national religion in the United States other than the Freedom From Religion Foundation? I don't think any court in America would, that's for sure. So that's number one. Number two, they're now going after the hotel chains which, of course, as you said, Logan, are private chains. They can do whatever they want.
Yeah.
I mean, they're not subject to this. But, and this is, I think, an important part, what they're trying to do is create this kind of atmosphere of almost like discrimination.
Right.
If you've got the Bible there and I know it's there, I am therefore, you know, feel like my life is being impacted in a negative way, and I don't want that experience. So the answer to them is to say no. And I need to update you on this. We sent a letter out already to the University of Northern Illinois, but we've got 163,646 signatures. I want to get it up to 200,000 as we go after these, if we get these letters out to these other hotel chains around the country, the ones that have been named. Jordan, do you have that list with you there again?
Yeah, I do. I can go through that. And this is, again, these are the hotels that received
yep.
the letter from the Freedom From Religion Foundation. It includes Wyndham Worldwide, Intercontinental, Choice Motels, which is Quality Inn, Hilton, the G6 Hospitality, which is Motel 6, Marriott International, Best Western, the Carlson Hotel Group, which is yep. the Radisson Carlson Country Inn, and the Starwood Hotels, which also includes the Sheraton brand, the W line, many different hotels. Those
yeah.
encompass basically all of the hotels you see, the major
the
chains in the world.
All right, we're going to take more of your calls when we come back from the break. We're going to take comments as well. Let me encourage you to sign on to this petition, aclj.org or 1-877-989-2255. And it's really simple. It's defend the Bible. And we're going to send this letter off to all the hotel chains. It's not threatening. We're going to say, look, here's what the law is. Don't be intimidated by this group. They never win cases. aclj.org or 1-877-989-2255. That's aclj.org or 1-877-989-2255. I think we're going to be able to announce probably in a few days that we're handling a case for a city that's got Freedom From Religion Foundation lawsuit. I'll know about that probably by tomorrow or Wednesday. So we'll keep you posted there again. aclj.org or 1-877-989-2255. And I urge everybody that's listening to sign on, whether you're watching us on Facebook or Periscope or online, or whether you're listening over radio, get engaged in this very, very early. So again, aclj.org or 877-989-2255. So that's aclj.org. 1-877-989-2255. Again, aclj.org or 877-989-2255. We'll be back with more in just a moment.
Bibles, they're as common in hotels as those little shampoos and soaps hidden away in nightstand drawers. To the Freedom From Religion Foundation, they're much more than that. They say they're a way to force one religion onto travelers. This one was easy and fast.
Yes, and Dan, you kindly chauffeured me when I was asked to speak at Northern Illinois University in DeKalb, Illinois. And you said, gee, you should look and make sure there isn't a Gideon Bible in our hotel room. And I was the skeptic, and I opened three drawers, no Bible. The fourth drawer, the bedside table, there it was. I was shocked.
These angry atheists will stop at nothing to attack Christianity. The American Center for Law and Justice has defeated this group numerous times in the past and is now mobilizing to combat this group's false and misleading information. Stand with the ACLJ now as we defend the Bible.
Let's go ahead and take a phone call.
All right, Kim is calling from Sun Valley, California. Welcome to Jay Psyche Live.
Hey, Kim.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
I just wanted to comment about the FFRF. I think they should put a warning on the JWs and also the Mormon so-called Bible.
We mean you're talking about the Book of Mormon that's in the Marriott hotels. Like, listen, I have no problem with the Book of Mormon being there. Like, I'm thrilled that the Gideon Bible's there. I mean, this is where, Kim, I think they're absurd. I think they are so afraid of anything religious, they don't want to do anything. Go ahead, Logan.
We have to be careful about that.
Yep.
You don't want to turn what they've said too. You don't want to be the people that are going, oh, well, it's fine to have the Bible, but it's not fine to have everyone else. You know, that is where, you know, it's a slippery slope, and it's actually the ridiculous statements they're making
yep.
when they're saying, we don't want the Bible, but we give you a nice alternative. That
you Darwin's know, Origin of the Species.
Right, which a lot of people just pick up and
But
read.
There is something else to this, and this is the more serious nature of this, and that is what they're trying to do is a form of basically intimidation. So they're trying to affect the bottom line by saying we're going to basically boycott businesses that have a Bible in the Gideon Bible in there. So again, I we're not for banning books. Jordan, they're the ones that are trying to ban books here.
Yeah, that's right. And this idea that ultimately it's choice by the companies, what they want to have in their drawers. Right. It's up to the institutions, organizations. It could be up to these universities in some extent, whoever's running these properties to decide. They get to make those kind of decisions as well. And so you start allowing this to creep in. That's not the right way to move yep. forward. The right way to move forward is to say, you know, as Christians, as most of the people listening to this broadcast likely are, we're confident in our faith. So if you right. see something you don't like in a drawer, you can close the drawer. You don't need to spend time with it. But that's what they're, I think there's, yep. it goes to that power issue that there is something there that they know has great impact on people.
Exactly correct. Let's go ahead and take Tommy's call. She's yeah. been holding from Facebook, and I'm going to send Tommy, as we send some of our callers today from radio as well, sending Tommy our book, Rise of ISIS. So, Tommy, go ahead.
You know, I watch your program every day. I've been becoming Thanks. More educated, and so I got contact from a pastor Saturday night saying that the little teeny town next to where I live is about 14 miles away, has maybe 500 people. I'm not sure the population, but tiny. They have a county fire department, and the fire department has a reader board, and there was a Christmas message on it.
Yep.
They used part of a scripture. It said, "Unto us a Savior is born, Merry Christmas." So the fire district, or the fire, one of the three fire commissioners told the fire chief someone had complained. He would not say whom, but he said that needs to go. So the reader board is now blank. One other person said they want the community Christmas tree taken down too.
Well, this is what they do. And what we need to do is, Tommy, get a hold of that city and get them a letter so they understand that they don't have to be intimidated by this. But this is, again, Jordan, they're not going to go to court most of the time. They do sometimes, they lose, but they'll do this intimidation technique.
Yeah, especially this last minute, so right before Christmas week and the holiday, yep. and so it's that pressure, it comes in, it's always this time of year,
yep.
and usually very late in the process so that they try to intimidate, and that's exactly what's happening, yep. Likely in your town in Washington State.
Yep, if you get us the name of the town, we'll get a letter off to them right away. Let's go ahead and take another call.
We're going to try to get through as many calls as possible. Frank is calling from Richmond. Frank, welcome to JSEC. You're live, you're on the air.
Hi, Frank.
Hello. Hey. So these folks are offended by the Bible
right.
in the room. What if I'm offended by the lumpy pillows and the ugly wallpaper? Does that mean they're going to remove that? Of course they're not.
All right, of course.
They're going to remove
it. Yeah. So go to another. What I say is don't open up the drawer if you're that offended by the Gideon. If you're but they take it to this unbelievable extreme of knowing it's in the room, therefore I'm offended.
That's right. If that's the case, then how do you even go about your daily life even moving right. forward? They really don't. I think that's the truth, is they don't really go a point. They don't want to pay the high prices to be proselytized to.
Well, that's what they're saying.
Then pick another chain or go stay with a friend, Airbnb, yeah. do
but
something
I need
else.
We do need to underscore that other than the University of Northern Illinois, nobody else has backed off on this.
Right.
And important here, the chains at Jordan that you mentioned, none of those chains have capitulated to them.
Yeah, that's right. But there is this overwhelming movement of political correctness
yeah, there is.
In the country. And that's what makes me somewhat concerned, is that even in the corporate world, we know that that exists. And so I think what they're doing with this letter is fishing, trying to find yep. maybe inside one of these chains, someone who is sympathetic, maybe a CEO who's sympathetic more to their views against religion. And so that's what they're out there. They're out on a fishing expedition to see what they can find.
All right, let's go ahead and take another. We're going to do rapid fire here. We're going to get through these four calls. Let's go.
All right, line four. Mike is calling from Johnstown, Pennsylvania. Welcome to JSEC Live. You're on the air.
Hey, Mike.
Yeah, guys. Hey, you know, if they would take that same hatred and that same animosity they have towards Jesus and put it towards George Washington, would we have to change the history books and declare George Washington was never a president?
And
or
the
what?
Answer to that is no. But this is, they are in the business of rewriting history. We're not letting them do that. I appreciate your call, Mike.
All right. Gene is calling from Colorado Springs, Colorado. Gene, you're on the air.
Hey, Gene.
Hey, I enjoy watching you on Facebook.
Great.
I really love the feed.
Listen, thanks.
Is this the Mikey Weinstein's organization?
No. Completely separate group.
Yep, separate group. That's the Military Religious Freedom Foundation. This is the Freedom From Religion Foundation. I'm sure on some issues they have they're like-minded in on some issues, but these are separate organizations.
Yeah, not the same. Yeah, yeah. That's I would say that's a good way of putting it, Logan.
All right, Jordan is calling. Not that Jordan, but the other Jordan from Douglasville, Georgia. You're on the air.
Hey, Jordan.
Hey, guys. Thank you for taking my call.
Sure.
I have a question. When did all this, in my opinion, garbage of religious and politically correct stuff really start taking a fast pace? I mean, I'm
well, they've been around for a long time. I mean, but Jordan, when did they I'd say in the last 10 years, they've gone to the level of obnoxious.
Yeah, originally these were more organizations for atheists, for non-believers gathering together, and I think it was actually pretty mundane. And then it grew, it was kind of a college town, and headquartered in Madison. These movements not making people feel more comfortable with their maybe that they're not believers. Again, I think it has this evangelist kind of tone to it.
Yeah.
But really, yeah, I think the late 90s into the 2000s. And I think that goes to where they saw the courts
right.
even questioning this, and they said, okay, let's start filing some lawsuits when we can
and, those
and
lawsuits,
try and see how
lose.
Far we can get.
Yeah, they lose those lawsuits. Grab Barbara really quick. Barbara
in South Dakota, you're on the air.
Real quick, Barbara.
Thank you. I have a question for you. With those stickers that the FFRF want to put on Bibles,
yep.
couldn't they legally get in trouble for vandalism?
Yeah, I think that's it. You bring up a really good point. Are they desecrating, forgetting the spiritual side of it, are they damaging somebody's property? And the answer to that is yes, they are.
Yeah, so it's definitely they're not the people doing it themselves. They're definitely encouraging it.
They are encouraging the violation, the desecration of property. They are. I mean, this is the nature of who they are. All right, folks, here's what we've got. I've got an email that's going out to you on our pro-life cases. Let me encourage you to sign that petition now to get your name on that brief to the Supreme Court. You can also go to aclj.org. Support our work. We're in a matching challenge campaign, folks. Any amount you donate, we're getting a matching gift for. The easiest way to do that is aclj.org. We'll be back with you tomorrow.
Bibles. They're as common in hotels as those little shampoos and soaps hidden away in nightstand drawers. To the Freedom From Religion Foundation, they're much more than that. They say they're a way to force one religion onto travelers. This one was easy and fast.
Yes, and Dan, you kindly chauffeured me when I was asked to speak at Northern Illinois University in DeKalb, Illinois. And you said, you should look and make sure there isn't a Gideon Bible in our hotel room. And I was the skeptic, and I opened three drawers, no Bible. The fourth drawer, the bedside table, there it was. I was shocked.
These angry atheists will stop at nothing to attack Christianity. The American Center for Law and Justice has defeated this group numerous times in the past and is now mobilizing to combat this group's false and misleading information. Stand with the ACLJ now as we defend the Bible.